I suppose you'd still be attractive to any man of spirit, though. There's something engaging about it, this goddess business. Something more challenging to the male than the more obvious charms.
Really?
Really. We're very vain, you know. This citadel can and shall be taken, and I'm the boy to do it.
You seem quite contemptuous of me all of a sudden.
No, Red. None of you. Never of you. Red, you could be the finest woman on this earth. I'm contemptuous of something inside of you. You either can't help or make no attempt to. Your so-called strength. Your prejudice against weakness. Your blank intolerance.
Is that all?
That's the gist of it. Because you'll never be a first-class human being or a first-class woman until you've learned to have some regard for human frailty. It's a pity your own foot can't slip a little sometime. But your sense of inner divinity wouldn't allow that. This goddess must and shall remain intact. There are more of you than people realize. A special class of the American female. The married maidens.
So help me, Dexter. If you say another word,
I'm through, Red. For the moment, I've had my say.
You can't marry that guy.
George, I'm going to. Why not?
Well, I don't know. I thought I'd be for it at first, but you just don't seem to match up.
Then the fool's with me.
Well, maybe so, but all the same, now you can't do it.
No?
No.
Come around about noon tomorrow. I mean today. Snob.
Say, what do you mean, snob?
You're the worst kind there is, an intellectual snob. You made up your mind awfully young, it seems to me.
Well, 30's about time to make up your mind. And I'm nothing of the sort, not Mr. Connor.
The time to make up your mind about people is never. Yes, you are. And a complete one.
You're quite a girl, aren't you?
You think?
Yeah, I know.
Thank you, Professor. I don't think I'm exceptional.
You are, then.
I know any number like me. You ought to get around more.
Yeah. Well, in the upper class? No, thank you.
You're just a mass of prejudices, aren't you? You're so much thought and so little feeling, Professor.
Oh, I am I?
Yes, you am, are you? Your intolerance infuriates me. I should think that of all people, a writer would need tolerance. The fact is, you can't be a first-rate writer or a first-rate human being until you've learned to have some small regard for human aren't the geraniums pretty, Professor?